The motor fails and he just wears a helpless grin. Don't bat your eyes and say, what a romantic spot we're in. Just leap out, crawl under the car, say, it's the gasket, and fix it in 2 seconds flat with a bobby pin. That's a good way to lose some hair. He takes you to a baseball game you sit knee to knee. He sets the nerves when up and that will what you'll see. Don't say, who wants some fun? This game's too hard for little old me. Just say, but are you nuts? With no outs, two men on base, and a left-handed batter coming up, he'll walk right into a triple play, just like in the fifth game of the World Series in 1923. Duh. That's a fine way to lose some man. A fine, 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 fine way to lose a man. A deadly way to lose a man. Just throw your knowledge in his face. He'll never try for second base. Beach that all the girlies adore. Swims bravely out to save you through the ocean's roar. Don't say, it thinks I would have drowned in just a second more. Just push his head under the water, yell, last one is a rotten egg, and race him back to shore. That's a swell way to lose some air. You've met your perfect mate and it's been love from the start. He says, you're the one to whom I give my heart. Don't say, I love you too, my dear. Let's never, never part. Just say, I'm afraid you've made a grammatical error. Well, it's not to who I give my heart, it's to whom I give my heart. You see, with the use of the preposition to, who becomes the indirect object, making the use of whom imperative, which I can easily show you by drawing a simple chart. Yeah. That's a sure way to lose a man. A sure, sure, sure way to lose a man. A split